The Theory and Practice of Editing New Yorker Articles. This was written by Walcott Gibbs around 1937, apparently at the request of Catherine White, who was then trying out a succession of new fiction editors. So what are we going to cut to if we cut off of this stuff?
Scenes in the film?
Someone else's problem.
Yeah, someone will edit it.
Writers always use too damn many adverbs. He said morosely, violently, eloquently, and so on. A writer who can't make his context indicate the way his character is talking ought to be in another line of work.
Modern art?
Modern art.
Our writers are full of cliches just as old barns are full of bats.
Supposed to be charming.
There's obviously no rule about this, except that anything that you suspect of being a cliché undoubtedly is one.
I only asked you to proofread it because I thought you'd be even more impressed by how good it already is.
Let's start with the typos.
Pieces about authors, reporters, poets, etc., are to be discouraged in principle. Nobody gives a damn about a writer or his problems except another writer.
Just try to make it sound like you wrote it that way on purpose.
Editing on manuscripts should be done with a black pencil, decisively.
1 hour to press.
You're fired.
Consider whether the last sentence of a piece is legitimate and necessary, or whether it is just an author showing off.
It came to be known as the Night of 1,000 Slugs.
On the whole, we are hostile to puns. Try to preserve an author's style. If he is an author and has style.